You want a piece of my heart.
Okay, everybody, I'm working up an appetite. That was a great little dance-off, but we're gonna do a beautiful pumpkin pancake recipe for the weekend. But I guarantee you, when you taste these, you're gonna wanna eat them every single day. And the great news is you can make larger batches, freeze them, and then you can just heat them up every day. So what we're gonna do is our main ingredient is pumpkin, and you have to get the pure pumpkin. Now, if you wanna use butternut squash or any other squash, you can, but the great thing about this is that there's so many vitamins in these squashes, particularly with pumpkin. So it actually makes the pumpkin pancakes very light and very nutritious. You don't leave the table feeling very full. So I think you're gonna love this recipe. So the first thing we have to do is we have to mix our dry ingredients. We have 1¼ cups of just regular flour, and we're just gonna pop it. I have the little sifter here. We're gonna pop that in here. That works out to be about 190 grams of flour. And then we're gonna put in the other dry ingredients, which are 2 teaspoons of baking powder. That's gonna make it really nice and fluffy. And it's really important to sift the ingredients because you're actually adding air to the dry ingredients, and that just makes them that much lighter. And then we're gonna use two tablespoons of sugar. And that's just gonna bring out the nice sweetness of the pumpkin, because that's not sweetened pumpkin. And then we're gonna add just a 1/2 teaspoon of salt. That makes sure with these recipes that you want to measure all the ingredients properly. And then this is pumpkin pie spice. Most shops in America carry them. In Ireland and over in the UK, it might be harder to find. So you just want to mix together cinnamon, ginger, cloves, and nutmeg. And we're going to use 1¼ teaspoons. Okay? And a quarter. And just sift that all together. Woo! And the nice thing about sifting it is if there's any hard lumps like that, it takes it all out for you. All right, so you've got that. We'll just kind of mix that up a little bit, and you'll see oh, that cinnamon flavor is beautiful. Great, so just set that aside for a second, and then we're gonna mix the wet ingredients. And we'll start with an egg, just one egg. And I always like to break it on the table as opposed to on the bowl, so that if a little piece of egg shell got in there, that would be a bit awkward. So just do it on the table. And then we're gonna put 1 cup of whole milk. And if you don't like dairy and you wanna use almond milk, you can do that as well. And then I've already measured out the pumpkin. It's 6 tablespoons of pure pumpkin. You can also, if you're weighing it out, it's about 100 grams. So that's already been measured out. Put that in there, and then we'll mix that together. Make sure you get all of it. It's so good. Do you know you don't have to save pumpkin just for Thanksgiving? In fact, the only thing that's really Thanksgiving about this recipe, you'll see in a minute, is my secret weapon. And then we have 2 tablespoons of melted butter. It's really important that after you melt it, you let it cool a little bit, because you don't want it to kind of scramble the egg. So we have 2 tablespoons of melted butter. And the nice thing about that is then when you go to cook your pancakes, you won't need to use a lot of oil or butter in the actual pan, because there'll be enough of that in there, okay? Over here, and that over here. And then we're just gonna sift that up. And you want to make sure that it's really well mixed. There. And if you want, you can even add a drop of vanilla to that, just to give it a little, another level of flavor. And now we're going to combine the two. So I'm going to pour that in here. There. And then I'm just going to stir that around. And you don't need to stir it too much. Just make sure that you get all of the flour mixing together. Like most pancake recipes, you don't want to over mix them, because then the pancakes don't stay as light and fluffy. All right, so there we are. All done, real quick. And then this is the secret weapon. I'm gonna use this to scoop up the batter and put it into the hot frying pan. So we're gonna go do that now. maybe a little bit strange, but I don't ever turn on my extractor fan when I'm cooking unless there's like smoke billowing all over, because I absolutely love the smell of cooking in the house. It's the best air freshener there could be, and especially these pumpkin pancakes with all the flavors of the cinnamon and the ginger and the cloves and the nutmeg. Oh my gosh, it's amazing. The batch that I made is about 10 pancakes, and what I like to do is serve them on a big platter when I'm having people over for brunch, and I take some beautiful pecans and I just crunch them all over the top like so. Woo! They go everywhere. That one's for my little dog Stella. She'll get a little taste. And then of course you have to use pure maple syrup from North America and just drizzle some over. And then I leave some of this on the table as well so that the guests can help themselves. A little weekend wonder, pumpkin pancakes. Delicious. Now that is a weekend wonder. That's gonna keep me going all day, and it's healthy and it's delicious. So delicious! I love it! Ooh, crunchy pecans. A new romance. This is my new romance.
You want a piece of my heart?